Hello everyone, my name is Saurabh Deshmukh, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchan Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to learn how to find the field variables or how to calculate the field variables within a triangular element using shape functions. The learning outcome. At the end of this session, the learner will be able to calculate field variable of triangular element using shape function. So this is our problem. The nodal displacements of the element are given below for the point I, J and K. Now we need to calculate the displacement at points 2, 2 and 3, 4. So now I will draw the diagram here first. So this is our Cartesian coordinates. This is our triangular element. This is our point I, this is J, and this is K. Okay, the coordinates of point I are 1, 1. The coordinates of point J are 8, 2. And coordinates of point K are 4, 6. Okay, now we need to calculate the displacement at point with Cartesian coordinates 2, 2 and 3, 4. Okay, so we know that u equals to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3. So now we need to first calculate the values of n1 n2 and n3. Here u1 u2 and u3 are nothing but ui uj and uk. We know their values. Okay, so I will write the values of ui uj uk here. It is ui uj and uk equals to, it is 2, 1 and 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. Okay, now we need to calculate the displacement at point 2, 2 and 3, 4. So how to calculate the n1, n2 and n3 here? So we will calculate for the point with Cartesian coordinates 2, 2. For 2, 2, we need to calculate the value of n1. Okay, so n1 equals to, now let's suppose the point 2, 2, let we name it as a P. So let assume that point P lies here, it is 2, 2. Now we'll join PK, PI and PJ. Okay, now there are three triangles. First one is IPJ, PJK and PIK. Okay, so we'll name it for the opposite of K, it is, this is triangle K. For the opposite triangle to the I is I and opposite to the J is J. Okay, now we need to calculate the shape functions of the point 2, 2 with respect to I. So how to find out it? It is area of, for calculating the shape functions with respect to point I, we need to take the triangle opposite to it. So it is area of triangle PJK upon area of triangle, it is whole triangle, it is IJK. Similarly, to calculate the value of N2, it is N2 equals to area of triangle. Now we need to calculate the value of A2, that is with respect to J, that is the shape functions of point 2, 2 with respect to J. So opposite to that, it is triangle PIK, PIK upon area of triangle IJK. And also N3 equals to, it is area of triangle, for the K, take the opposite triangle to it. So it will be PIJ. It is PIJ upon area of triangle IJK. Okay, so how to find the area of triangle? It is very simple. We need to find the determinant of their coordinates. So we'll first calculate the area of triangle IJK. Okay, so area of triangle IJK equals to, it is nothing but 1 by 2 into determinant of, the first column is 1, 1, 1, and for the in the second and third column, we fill the Cartesian coordinates of that point, of the vertices of that particular triangle, that is I, j, k. So what is the Cartesian coordinates of I? It is 1, 1. For j, it is 8, 2, and for k, it is 4, 6. So what is area of triangle I, j, k here? It is equals to 1 by 2 into bracket. It is 40 into minus 1 into 4 minus 2, it is minus 4. And 1 into 4 into minus 8, it is minus 4. So it will be equals to 16. Similarly, we will find the area of triangle PIJ, PIK and PIJ. Okay. So we will find here the area of triangle PJK equals to, it is 1 by 2 into determinant of, it is 1, 1, 1. The coordinates of point P are 2, 2, 8, 2, and 4, 6. So after calculating this, we will get 1 by 2 into, it is 40 minus 8, and this is also minus 8. So it will be equals to, it is 24 upon 2, it is 12. Similarly, area of triangle PIK equals to 1 by 2 into, it is 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 4, 6. So it is 1 by 2 into, this is 1 into 4 minus, it is 2, minus 2 into 6 minus 1, it is 5, minus 10, 2, this is plus 6. It is minus 2 upon 2, it is minus 1, but area cannot be negative, see it, so it will be 1. Similarly, area of triangle PIJ equals to, it is 1 by 2 into determinant of 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, and for J it is 1, 8, 2. Okay, so it is equals to, it is 1 by 2 into, this is minus 6, this is minus 2, and plus 2 into 7, it is 14. So it is equals to 6 by 2, it is 3. So we have calculated the area of triangles. Now we need to calculate n1, n2, n3. So we'll calculate it here. N1 equals to, what is it? N1, it is area of triangle PJI. PJI is 12 upon area of triangle IJK, it is 16. So 12 by 16 equals to, now N2 equals to, it is 1 by 16, and N3, it is 3 by 16. So if you calculate it by CALCI, by using the CALCI, we'll get N1 equals to 12 by 16, it is 0.75, N2 it is 0.0625, and N3 it is 0.1875. So now we need to calculate the displacement at point 2, 2. So at u at 2, 2 equals to N1. What is the value of N1? It is 0.75. We need to substitute this value in this equation. So 0.75 into ui. U1 is ui. It is 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. So 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus N2, it is 0.0625 into 1 into 10 raised to minus 3, that is UJ, U2 is nothing but, and plus N3 is 0.1875 into u3 is nothing but uk. It is 3 into 10 raised to minus 3, okay, equals to. So now we will substitute this value into the calc. So we will solve it here. It is 0.75 multiplied by 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus it is 0.0625 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus 0.1875 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 3. So it is 2.125 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. So u at 2, 2. These are the references. Thank you.